Today I will be telling you about the Transit Camp Westerbork. You're probably wondering what a transit camp is. It is a camp that the prisoners go to before they head off to the death camps. Before it was a transit camp, Westerbork used to be a refugee camp for Jews, and then the Nazis took over and made it into a transit camp.
Imogen, would you like to tell us about what life was like at Westerbork?
Well, Beatrice, Westerbork was a lot more, how should I put this? Well, more civilized than the other camps.
Really? How so?
When we first arrived at Westerbork, the Nazis tricked us all into thinking that the road ahead was not going to be as bad as we had imagined.
And how did they do that, Imogen?
We were fed pretty decent meals most of the time, and the Nazis weren't that harsh to us, and there was schooling for the children. And of course, at that time, I was one of those children.
And who was the teacher?
A Jewish woman, and there are also plays there. I enjoyed these very much as a child. There are also symphonies, one of the finest I have ever heard. But then the plays and symphonies had to stop. Because too many people were being deported.
Oh, so Westerbork was a little bit like community life, in a way?
Yes, it was in a way, but a dark shadow loomed behind all the activities the Nazis gave us. We all wondered where they went after being deported. The Nazis just said we were going off to work. But then the camp of Westerbork found out the truth, and complete chaos broke loose.
What was the worst part you remember about Westerbork?
The Nazis picked certain Jews to organize the deportation list, promising they were never going to be deported themselves. Jews were selecting other Jews for death. It was horrible. And in the end, everyone was deported, even the ones who were promised they weren't going to be.
The first camp leader of Westerbork was SS Lieutenant Colonel Dischner. He was an alcoholic who regularly whipped the inmates. He lasted only 6 weeks because he was not giving off the impression to the prisoners that the road ahead wasn't going to be that bad. Dischner was then replaced by Lieutenant Colonel Gemmiger. He made the unsuspecting Jews going through Westerbork believe that the future wasn't going to be so bad. Of course, he was just fooling them all. Theater became very popular at Westerbork when Max Enright came. The first theater performance he held was Shakespeare's Midsummer Night's Dream. The actors and actresses were not granted survival, so the cast was regularly changing from deportations. The performances finally stopped on October 1943 due to many deportations. The music at Westerbork included a choir, chamber music, ensemble, and a 30 to 40 person symphony. The symphony included some of Holland's most talented musicians. Everything was run by Jewish artists. They had a first-class orchestra, which was one of the finest throughout Holland. The Nazis used entertainment to hide that Westerbork was only a waiting room for death.
Bugle now, play it just for me. As the seasons change, remember how I used. used to be. Now I can't go on. I can't even start. I got nothing left, just an empty heart. I'm a soldier, wounded, so I must give up the fight. There's nothing more for me. Lead me away.